Ribbon Communications welcomes all our guests throughout the Americas to Ribbon 5G Perspectives. We're excited you've joined us. And now, Ribbon 5G Perspectives is pleased to welcome our first speaker, the CEO and President of Ribbon, Bruce McClelland.
Hi, everyone, and welcome to Ribbon's first 5G Perspectives event. I'm Bruce McClelland, President and CEO of Ribbon Communications. I joined Ribbon earlier this year and spent my entire 30-year career in telecommunications. I was really looking forward to living on a plane and getting a chance to meet with everyone at all the industry events, but so much for those plans. But it really has been amazing to see how effective the industry has been living with all the travel restrictions and working from home. And it's never been more important to have great networks and great connectivity, which is really going to be the focus of our discussion here today. I think we've organized just a great event. This will be a fast-paced 90-minute virtual conference to start a conversation with you on just how transformative 5G will be to society and to the overall economy. I've recently had discussions with a number of political leaders and staff in Washington, including members of the White House Science and Technology Office, the National Economics Council, the Senate and House Committees on Commerce and Technology, and staff from the FCC Commissioner's Office. There's great interest in Washington, as well as with governments worldwide, in the strong consumer and commercial benefits that will be enabled by 5G. And there's a clear consensus, we just need to be moving faster. I'd like to share a few data points that illustrate the potential impact of 5G. Omdia, a prominent market research firm, predicts that in 2035, 5G will enable more than $13 trillion of global economic output. That's the equivalent of the entire US consumer spending in 2019. Omdia also predicts that 5G traffic will grow more than 150-fold between 2020 and 2023. That's more than 15,000% in less than 3 years. At today's 5G Perspectives event, you'll hear an overarching theme: the future is now. The decisions being made today on how to design the network and the platforms being used will underpin the flexibility and capability of tomorrow's 5G infrastructure. And it's critical that we plan to support these future advanced services now. So, on with the conference. Jimmy Mizrahi, Ribbon's EVP for Packet Optical Networks, will kick off the dialogue. He became part of Ribbon earlier this year when we merged with ECI Telecom and has spent more than 20 years innovating in the packet optical network arena. Jimmy will discuss how service providers can ready themselves now to manage the ever-increasing demand for low latency and deterministic network connectivity that will further explode once 5G is fully deployed and exciting new applications come to market. We have some of the most flexible packet and optical 5G native solutions available to meet different service and network needs, including those of dynamic private 5G networks. Lynette Luna from Global Data is joining us to share her perspective on the world of cloud gaming, a real global, real-time phenomena that demands high-speed networks, low latency, and resilient connectivity for a superior quality experience. Lynette will also share data from a study that we commissioned last quarter that quantifies the significant immediate revenue opportunity available to those companies that have the foresight to meet the challenge. You'll then hear from Kevin Riley, Ribbon's CTO. Kevin will focus on how we can prepare ourselves to manage the ever-increasing complexity of the rapidly evolving networks. At Ribbon, we have a portfolio of analytics solutions that help many of our customers manage their networks today and are ready to support distributed, flexible 5G networks. I think advanced analytics will become a mission-critical part of service adoption as 5G scales. We round out our agenda with a panel of industry experts sharing their perspectives on 5G today and tomorrow. We're pleased to have with us Mike Roberts, principal consultant for Omdia's service provider markets, Scott Wilkinson, lead analyst, optical and packet transport hardware for Signal AI, and Adora Alkalaki, principal analyst, service provider operations and IT with Omdia. And most important, you'll hear the perspective from many of our customers and partners sharing how they anticipate 5G will impact their companies and markets. We're broadcasting this event three times to be convenient to our customers and partners around the world. Throughout the program, you can send us questions in the chat box, which will be monitored by Ribbon subject matter experts. With that, I want to once again thank you for joining us. This is just going to be the beginning of an ongoing dialogue that we want to have with you about how we can work together to meet the promise of 5G. Thank you.
5G is now and nationwide. It's here. And it bolsters our access, broadens our connectivity, and it's bettering our lives. With ultra broadband, people on the move can stream, share, and play anywhere. Smart cities are more efficient, more aware, and more secure, while rural areas are more connected than ever. And 5G changes countless industries with mass machine-to-machine and IoT communications like agriculture, energy, transportation, healthcare. We have all heard the 5G promise before. But how will your network deliver? Ultra-low latency, high reliability, security, deterministic behavior, monetization, migration, and all while providing an evolution path to next-generation services? Ribbon's 5G native solutions deliver on the 5G promise, allowing you to deliver secure, deterministic services that are powered by programmable hybrid network slicing and advanced analytics, so you can generate new revenue services today. Ribbon Native 5G Solutions, how your network delivers. Ribbon 5G Perspectives welcomes our next speaker, the EVP of Packet Optical Strategy, Jimmy Mizrahi.
Hi, my name is Jimmy Mizrahi. I'm EVP in Ribbon Communication for Packet Optical Transport Strategy. The communication world is growing through a real revolution that we have not seen in the past. This will enable significant changes in our life that will impact almost every industry and everything we do. I'd like to mention a few example applications where we'll see such impact. Smart cities with variety of new services such as public safety will be enhanced, street light will be automated, high-speed internet will be available across the city, and many more advanced services will become available to the resident. AR and VR services that will enable us to take information and content visually in the same way we see the real world. It will enable to introduce to our life a huge number of applications based on these technologies. New cloud-based gaming will enable kids and adults to play from their smartphone anytime, anywhere. And the Internet of Things, with millions of connected devices, will improve our life in many ways, making it possible to control all devices around us remotely. Those are only a few examples, and we'll see many more exciting applications such as e-learning, autonomous cars, drones, healthcare, robots, and many more. We are facing a new age of communication between humans to humans to machines, and machines to machines. Those exciting changes will have a huge impact on the telecom network. The new emerging applications and services will generate dramatic increase in the network traffic and massive bandwidth demand, much more than what the current network can support. Those services will bring with them new requirements that the new network should support, such as fast response time and very low latency, or other services will require very high availability. As the service requirements become more differentiated, the telecom network will play more and more key role in enabling those services. Together with that, the massive increase in scale is making it essential to improve the cost efficiency in every aspect, density, power consumption, simplifying network operation to shorten the time to market of a new services, much faster than what we expect in 4G networks. But the new network architecture is not imposed only by service demand. There are other considerations which are leading to new infrastructure design. Convergence of the RAN and the wireline, for example, is essential in order to enable any-to-any connectivity. Security of the network and the services has become a major factor. The new service demand are driving the telecom operator to invest in the network to address this new requirement. 5G is designed to accommodate those services needs via new networking approach, such as edge computing and storage, that scaling down to the network edge to improve response time and save bandwidth, as well as automation and programmability, which are not nice to have anymore and required to support real-time, dynamic, and reliable communication. Half of the world population does not have reliable broadband access. The cost of delivering fixed broadband has continually been challenging. Being able to deliver high-capacity communication at any time from any location is costly and in some cases even not feasible. Especially in this period of time when many people are working from home, the need for high-capacity, reliable broadband connectivity is becoming even more important. Another challenge we can see is the new application needs like online gaming, which enable people to play with their smartphone anywhere with the same experience as playing with their laptop. Using AR and VR for gaming application, as an example, require very low latency to ensure live experience at any location, anytime. This creates a challenge to the telecom operator to meet those service requirements. In other area, the enterprise market is looking how to modernize their infrastructure. As 5G started to ramp up, we see the enterprises looking for the next step to deploy 5G network and consider their deployment options. They are looking how to enable IoT connectivity, mobility, remote control in a secure and dynamic environment. Security, network slicing will remain an attractive option for them. In the next few years, we expect service provider will offer network slicing as cost-effective solution for the enterprise market, as they will pay only for what they will use. 5G is massively growing market, which create new business opportunities for the service provider. While multiple services with variety of demand will share the same infrastructure, slicing will play a key role to enable those business opportunities. For many of these applications, secured slides with low latency is mandatory requirement. The next generation 5G networks impose major end-to-end architecture changes. Evolution of the RAN to virtualize and open, cloudification of the core for monolithic EPC into cloud native core, and disaggregation of the core function and creation distributed core and radio function. Those architectural changes influence the transport domain dramatically, especially with regard to end-to-end traffic management and traffic steering. In the last 15 to 20 years, ribbon ACI solutions have been evolving from one mobile generation to another, starting with 2G mobile backhauling, migration to 3G, and then to 4G. As we speak, we are still deploying 4G networks evolving to 5G with some of the largest mobile operators. Ribbon ACI 5G solution have been designed to accommodate the current and the future network needs. Our solution support full 5G native, access to core backhaul solution covering layer 0 to layer 3, scalability, as the capacity has become a major issue, we support the required increase in network capacity and interface speed. Network optimization using sophisticated multi-layer algorithm, enhanced timing accuracy as required in 5G network based on 1588 class C and D, low latency and variety of slicing capabilities to enable service differentiation and advanced 5G application, programmability and openness using a standard interfaces that allowed us to connect to any ecosystem the customer has. Finally, yet importantly, the Ribbon solution is fully secured with holistic security package that cover the NE and the traffic. Ribbon unique hybrid slicing capabilities enable our solution to process massive number of differentiated services while each has unique requirement. With slicing, we can divide all the services in the network into groups, while each group process the services based on the same performance need. We have chosen the hybrid slicing approach to be able to provide both strict and lenient isolation with the ability to meet diverse security needs. Three main types of use cases were considered for our hybrid slicing design. First, infrastructure sharing, sharing the resources in the network with MVNO, for example, or any other sharing models which require segregation in order to secure each customer and its specific service needs. Second, The new upcoming 5G services, especially ultra-reliable, low-latency communication-based services, which stretch the network demand with highly challenging requirements such as very low latency, high security, capacity, scale, and reliability. Strict isolation between the different slices enables to secure traffic, and this has become a mandatory requirement. The third one is new secured business model, such as private network slices, which is on top of the public operator network. The private networks require strict isolation and high level of service assurance. Hybrid slicing approach will allow the operator to split the services between soft slice, hard slice, and any mix between the soft and the hard slices. The advantage of hard slicing is that it provides deterministic bandwidth throughout the network and create physical-like isolation from other slices. Private networks are deployed for a variety of industry entities, including power utilities, oil and gas, mining, government, manufacturing, and many more. Those enterprises are planning a migration to private mobile network as part of their network and modernization plan. The enterprises likely to have two options. It can connect to a public 5G network and lease a network slice, or it can deploy its own private 5G network by purchasing and building its own infrastructure using its own spectrum. In both options, sharing the infrastructure while still maintaining the physical segregation with high level of security is required. By using the hybrid slicing concept, the enterprise can fully evolve its network modernization plan while ensuring the services assurance in highly reliability and secured manner. Hybrid slicing is the only way to ensure physical isolation of critical services from the non-critical traffic. It will also enable maintaining network efficiency together with optimized network costs. Ribbon 5G solution include three main building blocks. Neptune product line that provide the full access to core packet switching solution and support the different mobile generation in a single platform. Neptune provide native 5G solutions supporting all 5G requirements, starting with carrier class architecture, high accuracy timing solution, soft and hard slicing, and enhanced security. Apollo product line that cover access to core and long-haul optical solution. It support both flavor of solution, OTN switching and transport, with full interoperability between the two flavor of solution. Apollo product line that cover access to core and long-haul optical solution. It support both flavor of solution, OTN switching and transport with full interoperability between the two flavor of solution. Apollo also support colorless, directionless, and contentionless configuration, enabling the customer to deploy a complete dynamic optical layer. Any wavelength can be routed and rerouted through the network to any direction with no limitation. The third building block is cloud-native SDN domain orchestration use, which provides set of application to plan, control, manage, and automated transport domain and virtualized edge. It covers the full network and service lifecycle and reduces significantly the operation complexity, optimizes network resources, and accelerates response time. The Muse domain orchestration connects the Ribbon solution to the customer ecosystem. The solution is fully open and programmable and can be connected to any ecosystem and any vendor the operator may choose. The Muse system covers the entire lifecycle of the network, from network design, provisioning, resource optimization, restorations, maintenance and troubleshooting, as well as statistic and network analysis. Our solution manages multiple layers with full visibility and provisioning capabilities. Multi-layer view enables not only a smart networking, but also an efficient usage of the network resources and significantly increase reliability and availability of the resources. The multi-layer capability is available in two modes of operation. Offline network planning with set of tools such as multi-layer failure simulation, as well as online planning based on optimized path computation and centralized restoration decision. When setting a new path, this function takes into consideration the network layers and topology, optical impairment, slicing, and latency needs. Being able to collect information and monitor the network in both IP and DWDM layers, together with analytics engine, we can predict the network event to support higher network availability and more efficient use of the network resources. With the arrival of the 5G services, we are now all in the 5G highway to new exciting world. But 5G is not just another evolution of the mobile network. it is a real revolution that will change our future in many aspects. 5G will change the way that we work, the way that we live, and the way that we experience things. No doubt it will have significant impact on our society. The revolution has already begun, and gradually, in the next few years, we'll experience significant changes in the way that we consume digital communication. 5G will deliver connectivity up to 100 times faster than anything that has come before. It will create new opportunities and new markets and will empower many new services. In many ways, the impact of 5G may be revolutionary as much as the impact of electricity and automobile when they first arrive. 5G will create opportunities for those telecom operators who will develop the infrastructure at the right time to support today's and tomorrow's services. Ribbon 5G solution will enable you to be ready for the future with comprehensive set of solutions that can take you from 4G to 5G with cost-effective and secure solution. It meets all the challenges and requirements of the new 5G services. Once you deploy Ribbon solution, you are securing your investment and you are ready to support all the new services that will be available in the future. Thank you.
Hi, everyone. Thank you for joining the Ribbon 5G Perspectives Conference. My name is Adam Coppi, and I lead the technology strategy, architecture, and planning team for Verizon. Let's talk about 5G. With its fundamental capabilities, 5G is shifting the perception of what's possible as we usher in the fourth industrial revolution. Verizon has led the way in developing and deploying 5G and accelerating 5G innovation. In 2015, we created the 5G Technology Forum, bringing together key partners in the chipset, device, and infrastructure community to move the entire 5G ecosystem forward. Our first mover advantage in testing and deploying millimeter wave spectrum, along with our engineering expertise, our fiber assets, and the strategic partnerships we have in place, put us in the best position to deploy this technology. We were the first in the world to launch a commercial 5G mobile network with a commercially available 5G-enabled smartphone and have been deploying 5G rapidly ever since. We have been encouraged by the pace of development in the industry and are proud to play a leadership role in that development. We have been using the latest technologies and platforms to deploy the most technologically advanced 5G, from the basic architecture and design of the network to its deployment. Verizon's 5G network is designed to be virtual from the core to the far edge. It combines end-to-end fiber resources throughout the network and uses a large deployment of small cells and significant spectrum holdings, particularly in the millimeter wave bands. This has allowed us to provide a keenly differentiated experience for our customers and lays the foundation for extraordinary innovation and growth in the future. We believe 5G will touch nearly every industry sector, impacting the global economy in a profound way and dramatically improving our global society. The capabilities of this new technology for consumers and businesses are almost unlimited. And thanks to the early and ongoing coordination with partners around the world, we've already gotten a strong glimpse into future solutions that would be built on top of our 5G platform. 5G technology, as exciting as it is just starting to evolve to reach its potential. Working with our strategic suppliers and countless partners who will build solutions on top of our industry-leading 5G network, we will continue to advance 5G technology innovation. As we have throughout our history, Verizon will continue to deploy the most advanced technologies and the highest quality networks with the best reliability for our customers. And we will continue to pull together stakeholders across multiple industries to become a dynamic and exciting ecosystem to take advantage of this advanced technology. Our industry knows 5G will change the world, and Verizon is committed to leading that charge with urgency and purpose. Stay safe and healthy, and I thank you for your time.
Gaming is not just for kids anymore. There are more than 2.7 billion gamers worldwide. And games are not just at home anymore. They're in the cloud, with mobile gaming leading the way. All gamers have the same enemies: latency, reliability, and congestion. But they're willing to pay for a competitive edge. 5G can give them that edge anywhere. Will your network deliver? If it does, your subscribers will grow. With Ribbon's 5G native transport network, everyone wins. With less latency and rock-solid reliability, 5G disaggregates radio and core resources to improve performance. And Ribbon's transport network dynamically adds capacity and connectivity when needed, while maintaining a predictable and deterministic network. This is a matter of life and death for a gamer.
Ribbon's hard slicing capabilities keep the gaming traffic on its own slice and bypasses oversubscribed packet switches. And gamers love their own slice. These network slices are not only satisfying, they're secure. Network connectivity and capacity follows gamers wherever they go, keeping them on top of their game. And if the gamers win, you win. Deliver the 5G network your customers deserve, one slice at a time. Ribbon 5G Native Solutions.
Ribbon 5G Perspectives welcomes our special guest speaker, a principal analyst at Global Data, Lynette Luna.
So I'm Lynette Luna. I cover the consumer services and devices market for Global Data, and one of my primary areas is looking at 5G service and monetization opportunities. And a key one that's widely talked about is 5G cloud gaming. And in fact, you know, it's a leading consumer use case. So my goal here is to really give you a quick view on how that's evolving and how carriers can play in this space. So it's clear that mobile games now outstrip other forms of gaming. We're seeing statistics that show 71% of internet users gaming on their smartphones. We're seeing billions in revenue projected and devices that are capable of running rich graphical gaming. And the other trend coming together really has been fueled by the popularity of Fortnite, which continues to generate both a massive amount of revenue and loyalty. Amazingly, it's been several years. It really has pushed both cross-platform gaming and a whole social networking effect, as Fortnite players really share a common interest, vocabulary and platform. And that really creates a lot of loyalty. And then there's another element here too. If there's any upside to the COVID-19 pandemic, it's gaming. A slew of companies really have seen a huge uptake in demand for games. That's everybody from telecom operators to developers to distributors. And so we expect this greater interest in gaming during this pandemic to really accelerate a shift towards the delivery of games via cloud-based platforms. And the industry really now sees potential in this distribution model, with mobile really being a catalyst. And we're seeing more gaming companies release higher end titles on mobile. And this, of course, really bodes well for 5G. Naturally, consumers will be demanding better quality. The gaming industry also sees an ultimate end game where PC and console gaming will be largely replaced by gamings hosted in the cloud and accessed via thin clients in the long term. And that gaming on demand model is really picking up based on success of video streaming and cloud storage, with the objective of providing gamers with frictionless and direct playing abilities across multiple devices. And this is still in its infancy, but we have Google Stadia and Microsoft as some of the most well-known in the market, and they're starting to come to the forefront. The pending introduction of cloud gaming from Microsoft is set to launch on September 15 on Android in select countries, with about 100 titles. So with this backdrop, we come to the crux of the discussion, the promise of 5G in gaming. And cloud gaming services has the potential to really democratize gaming. But one main barrier to entry remains, and that's high-speed internet with the requisite network attributes around low latency and capacity. And in the future, a large portion of cloud gaming traffic will continue to travel over fixed and Wi-Fi networks, just like we see today for streaming video. But 5G and fixed 5G networks should also really carry a large proportion, especially when carriers can engineer networks to accommodate cloud gaming. And one of the most important features here is latency. For cloud gaming to work properly and mimic really console type gaming, 5G really needs to deliver very low latency levels. Edge computing will be a key piece of technology to target premium users here. Even with 5G, you can lose that low latency advantage if the cloud facilities processing data are many miles away. So edge computing really puts the processing capability closer to users. And as much as 5G has the opportunity to transform gaming, there are some challenges. For one, cloud gaming is a long tail business, even though we're seeing an acceleration thanks to COVID and other business issues. These are clearly early days, and the quality of service and the cost of delivery and latency aren't quite there yet. Platforms can only function seamlessly if users have access to fast and stable broadband speeds with over a large footprint. So we aren't likely to see those owning consoles really abandoning their hardware en masse. So cloud gaming will be more of an opportunity to tap into different types of users, more casual users. And as I just mentioned, 5G coverage will continue to be a work in progress. Millimeter wave deployments are ideal for cloud gaming, but they certainly won't be everywhere. So mobile deployments face that same obstacles as 4G in the early years around difficulty penetrating homes and depending on spectrum choices. Spectrum choices, of course, greatly impact data speeds right now. Those relying on low band aren't seeing a huge bump in speed over today's LTE networks. And that will continue to evolve as carriers devote more spectrum to 5G. And then just like streaming video services, content really is king in cloud gaming. Premium content must be available if these services are to seriously challenge consoles and digital distribution platforms. And then another issue is Apple that has really come to the forefront recently with Microsoft. It bans third-party cloud gaming apps on iOS, and that's why all the cloud gaming apps we've seen so far are on Android. So depending on Apple's stance, a lot of carriers and gaming companies could be missing out on some large opportunities without a holistic mobile presence here. And then finally, where does edge computing go in the network? To bring edge computing to every cell site would be a massive and expensive undertaking. Exactly where those elements should reside will really depend on distance and cost. And there's really a recognition that carriers need to develop viable business models and use cases based on edge computing. Gaming alone just won't be the cost justification here. And then when we talk about carriers, how can mobile carriers play in the cloud gaming space? You know, the obvious play really is simply being a connectivity partner. And carriers are not really keen on that. They would like to avoid that proverbial dumb pipe play that's so prevalent in the 4G era, where the majority of the innovation has really come from over-the-top players in the consumer space. So telcos really are realizing that partnerships are key enablers to monetizing all sorts of 5G applications, and really gaming is no different. And so when I talk to carriers, they really have a lot of different ideas about how to play in the space. The business case here is really far from settled. And this is really evidenced by the early moves in this space. For example, we see the gamut of relationships. Sunrise in Switzerland is white labeling an app from GameStream. SK Telecom is more of a technical partner with Microsoft. And we see Telekom Germany recently unveiling its own proprietary cloud gaming platform. And then we also see Verizon is powering a number of esports events and organizations. So these are really some early examples, but then there's a lot of talk about leveraging partnership with gaming providers and really putting a bit more skin in the game as networks mature to bring in elements such as mobile edge computing and other network attributes for things like B2B2C type of arrangements. And that really could mean down the line selling 5G services to other businesses, which then would sell them as part of their offerings for their own customers. So in the case of 5G, we really could see faster video streaming, interactive multiplayer gaming, VR and AR games and experiences. And so it's clear that gaming really is a multifaceted opportunity without a best practices established. And so we'll continue to see a number of partnerships and go-to-market strategies. A couple of things that I like to recommend to carriers is to really whet the appetite for 5G gaming is to really deploy a 5G fixed wireless gaming play to demonstrate the technology capabilities. There's a lot of carriers that are embarking on both a fixed and mobile 5G deployment. That's most prevalent in Europe. But cloud gaming really can early on make a big impact on the fixed deployment. And many carriers are casting a wide net for 5G subscribers this way, so they're able to do it via plug-and-play CPE devices. And so there's this real opportunity for a whole bundle of gaming. We have video and other services with a key benefit that fixed 5G should be able to offer really a consistent data speed to enable a quality gaming experience. And then carriers can gather best practices and follow on with fixed and mobile 5G gaming. Attracting gaming users will really require more than offering a service and a partnership. That's another recommendation there. carriers really should look to affinity groups, merchandising, gaming hubs, entertainment, content, that's now really heavily tied to popular games like Fortnite. Gaming hubs are another big one that complement cloud gaming. I think simply offering a gaming app for a few months and hoping the gamer will buy into it is really not all that realistic for this market. Like I said at the beginning, games like Fortnite really have demonstrated that gaming is part of a social fiber, and carriers really need to work on tapping into that. And that's a lot of information to throw at you, but that really concludes my presentation. And I'd really like to thank the people at Ribbon for inviting me to speak with you today.
Good morning. My name is Gilles Garcia, and I'm the Senior Director for Wired and Wireless at Xilinx. Xilinx is the inventor of the FPGA, of the programmable SoCs, and now the EGA. Our highly flexible programmable silicon, enabled by a suite of advanced software and tools, drive rapid innovation across a wide span of industries and technologies. From consumer to cars to the cloud through the network, Xilinx delivers the most dynamic processing technology in the industry, enabling rapid innovation with its adaptable intelligent computing. We are building the adaptable intelligent cloud. Thank you for the question. Xilinx is addressing quite a large scope of markets, from consumer to automotive, test and measurement, data center, aerospace and defense, and of course telecommunication with wired and wireless. Especially on the 5G, Xilinx has been involved from the beginning on the 3GPP standard consortiums, and more recently, a few years ago, starting also to contribute quite a lot on the O-RAN, Open RAN, Alliance, and with the technology that we have developed for this 5G market, we have been able to address quite a large set of applications, from radio to baseband, accelerator in the baseband, backhaul, fronthaul, and of course, cores applications, where you need a very flexible type of technology and solutions to address new demands for the 5G services. The 5G market is developing much faster than the 4G market for the same in-time comparison. But nevertheless, the 5G is still at the beginning of the deployment. The first commercial deployment occurred last year. It was in Korea. The trials started a few years ago back in 2017-2018 timeframe. And Xilinx has been largely involved on both the trials and the first commercial deployment. But this is just the beginning. The 5G market will probably have 2 to 3 generations of platforms and systems before it matures completely. So we are just at the beginning, fast beginning, but still at the beginning of the 5G deployment. First of all, we have been working with Ribbon for quite a number of years. Ribbon, as one of the leaders in the packet and optical network, was a natural fit for Xilinx technology. To be more specific about the 5G innovation that we have been doing together, leveraging the experience of Ribbon into the packet world with Xilinx technology and the IP solutions for 5G was a natural fit. But we did it in a very innovative way and with a new approach to this market. We decided to mutualize our design, meaning that Ribbon was looking at the architecture. We were mutualizing design, IP, and design services approach in order to speed up the development and bring Xilinx technology and IP to the solution in order to really provide a hybrid network slicing innovative solution for this market. And so that's how Xilinx and Ribbon has been putting their energy and their leadership together to provide this new hybrid slicing solution to the market with a new design approach that we have been working with Ribbon together. Network slicing has been a very hot subject, and it's still a hot subject in all the discussions in the 5G market. Operators are definitely looking for network slicing to help segregating and isolating 5G services and 5G users, one from the other. How to warranty that a service will have the right bandwidth, the right latency, when not impacting the other one that need to be more secure, for example. And this is how the network slicing has become a key part of the 5G deployment and the rollout of the 5G in order to ensure protection of the services, isolation of the services, and even segregation of users. How can you have for the operator SLAs in place with gaming, for example, gaming users that are looking for very low latency and high bandwidth, and they will be paying more for that, but how do you manage your network associated to that? And so Ribbon has been coming out with a hybrid network slicing solution, which is quite innovative from our perspective. And we expect this solution to be able also to address the network slicing on the private networks. Because similarly to the mobile operators, private networks like large enterprise companies want to be able to segregate different services that they have as part of their enterprise, from their supply management to their HR systems, to their maintenance services, to their video streaming or their user experience site. So they will need as well to be able to manage and to segregate, isolate those services one from the other.
Our next speaker knows how to dig into the analytics. We welcome the CTO of Ribbon, Kevin Riley.
Hello, everyone. My name is Kevin Riley, and I'm the CTO for Ribbon Communications. Thank you for affording me the next 15 to 20 minutes to discuss the opportunity and complexity of 5G and how to best plan the journey by architecting big data analytics, machine learning, and artificial intelligence into every aspect of the 5G network architecture. It is clear that 5G is a catalyst for change with far-reaching impacts. 5G is so much more than a speed bump, and unlike previous mobile technology evolution, 5G will transform our lives and how we transact business. The introduction of ultra-low reliable latency communications, massive machine-type communications, and enhanced mobile broadband will usher in a new world of applications, use cases, and user experiences. 5G is also a means to pull through and accelerate many adjacent technologies. Of course, with this opportunity comes a great deal of challenge and complexity. 5G brings a level of network and operational complexity that we have not seen before. The previous models for migrating technology and network operations will not work and must be redefined as we move into a world of mobile networking that is on demand, adaptive, and highly distributed.
We've all heard the 5G wave is coming. It's not coming. It's here, and its data is about to surge. Today's networks need to be smarter, more reliable, and predictable than ever before. But where do you start? First, you need deep insights to know your network, your customers, and to deliver immersive experiences. Next, your network needs advanced intelligence with on-demand resource allocation to handle traffic. Finally, you need automation to unlock and deliver critical services and orchestrate resources. Delivering on service agreements and customer experiences becomes more complex as networks swell with 5G traffic.
Let's first spend some time talking about the technology acceleration that 5G will drive. 5G will either leverage directly or serve as a delivery vehicle for the following key technologies. Network slicing will transform the RAN into a granular resource supporting multiple service levels and tenants. Mobile edge computing will power low latency applications from the telco edge to the premise to the device. SDN will provide the network flexibility in real time to facilitate workload orchestration via MEC and network on demand. And the 5G service-based architecture will demand that vendors adapt a cloud-first mindset, leveraging containers, microservices, and cloud best practices. These technologies, in concert with 5G, will unlock new use cases in the areas of autonomous machines, augmented and virtual reality, telemedicine, immersive entertainment, machine control fueling Industry 4.0, and smart everything, including cities, urban infrastructure, and entertainment venues. As this story of technology fueling new use cases plays out, there are important overarching themes to keep in mind. The network edge is blurring and extending to the premise and device. The network is becoming a dynamic on-demand resource as services distribute. And latency, scale, bandwidth, and resiliency must be assured. In short, we have many, many more things running across a broader network footprint with demands that we have never seen before. Which leads us to consider the 5G operational challenges. There will be many thousands of microservices running in the 5G infrastructure, which will generate a data telemetry tsunami that will overwhelm network operators who do not evolve their network operations technologies. The move to a multi-vendor software-based architecture running across multiple domains will greatly increase the surface area of attack on infrastructure and services, putting increased pressure on the security posture of the network. Optimally allocating network resources and services on demand is a new operational model that will demand unprecedented levels of visibility, closed-loop automation, and service-level monitoring. With the number of machines on the network projected to exceed 20 billion by 2025, network operators are faced with a geometrically increasing demands for endpoint authentication, authorization, monitoring, and security. And last but not least, the 5G evolved edge that distributes through the network to the device with multiple compute points along the way creates previously unforeseen workload management challenges. To effectively unlock the value of 5G and manage the operational challenges I've highlighted, operators must distribute intelligence throughout the network from the core to the edge to the premise and to the device. This distributed intelligence must be architected from the start in conjunction with a mindset change within the operator or enterprise to embrace, utilize, and monetize the data in their networks as a critical component of a successful transition to 5G. Highly granular user, device, application, and network insights are central to tackling concerns weighing on operators as they move to 5G. Our perspective at Ribbon is that the top of mind 5G concerns for operators fall into four primary categories. First, how to monetize. How do operators ensure use case success and customer experience? Operators looking to increase their revenues by monetizing their data assets face a great number of challenges, including which use cases and customers they should focus on for highest return, how to comply with their customer privacy policies, and how to create new business sales and marketing channels. How to optimize. Software centricity drives on-demand, real-time service models, which in turn drives complexities. In the face of this, network operations must be re-engineered to get the most out of new 5G network capabilities. The geometric increase in threat surface area threatens brand reputation. Security architectures must advance. And lastly, how to minimize cost. 5G migration requires a significant upfront investment. 5G complexity will drive operational costs that must be contained, and operators can ill afford material increases in operational expense. So how do we best realize the advantages and opportunities unlocked by 5G, and at the same time, manage and mitigate these challenges? At Ribbon, we believe that the 5G opportunities and challenges are underpinned by analytics. A proper 5G analytics strategy must be grounded in state-of-the-art user, device, and machine monitoring and modeling, data enrichment driving actionable data insights, adaptation and automation in support of on-demand services and networking, all operating at machine speed and 5G scale across the network. Leveraging analytics in this manner throughout the 5G infrastructure will greatly reduce the risk, complexity, and cost that we've discussed, while at the same time unlocking the value that is the promise of 5G. At Ribbon, we believe that analytics is critical to successful 5G operationalization and monetization, which is why analytics is central to our mobile strategy and proven with mobile network operators across the world that have chosen our Ribbon Analytics platform. Let's take a closer look at the analytics solution space that we are focused on at Ribbon. The analytics portfolio consists of operations, security, and monetization solutions. Our operations applications provide a comprehensive network view across multiple dimensions, including service, network, cell, and device. The solution helps network planning and engineering teams understand network behavior for optimization, troubleshooting network issues, and modeling trends for network planning. Our security applications detect and alert operators to malicious activity on IP data and real-time communications traffic. Automated threat intelligence and security enforcement decisions can be broken across the network, creating an overarching security umbrella that greatly reduces the threat landscape. Our monetization applications enable operators to monetize usage data and location information with internal marketing departments or with third parties, while fully complying with privacy policies. These applications are in production networks today and ready-made to support the migration to 5G. With the 5G analytics application domain set, let's now dive into how mobile operators can achieve superior outcomes with analytics. Ribbon Analytics helps network operators integrate disparate data sources more easily and consistently via the following. Pre-built mobile network adapters. The platform can attach to or pull from third-party radio, EPC, and IMS infrastructure, or leverage the Ribbon mobile software probes to directly ingest user and control plane data. An optimized data lake and distributed ETL pipeline ready-made for edge compute to store data more cost-effectively. And applications that analyze data more accurately to better quantify network behavior, service behavior, customer experience, customer preferences, and customer needs. This suite of capabilities enables operators to secure the network, assure the SLA, monetize subscriber data, understand trends in real-time communications and IP data usage, identify abuse, reduce churn, forecast growth, and so much more, which is why we are very focused on 5G analytics at Ribbon. The key DNA of the Ribbon analytics solution consists of the following. The platform is hyperscale and architected for the 5G data tsunami. The data pipeline is architected to process and extract value from massive data feeds, delivering optimized processing of big data for any application. We have developed high-performance virtual protocol analyzers, delivering real-time cross-correlation, mobility, and session management. Our ability to scale is in action today in mobile networks, supporting 16 terabytes of data and 114 billion records per day in one mobile network for data monetization, and 3 billion records per day across 30 million Volte subscribers in another mobile network for service and customer assurance. The platform is cloud native, architected for the distributed service-based 5G architecture with a decomposable ETL pipeline, supporting ingest and enrichment at the edge, backed by deeper training and analysis in the core. And engineered for vertical and horizontal scaling utilizing containers, microservices, and REST APIs. The platform is cognitive, implementing machine learning and artificial intelligence technology for adaptive monitoring and troubleshooting of network performance to identify and mitigate issues before they become service impacting, minimizing downtime. The platform orchestrates closed loop automation, simplifying network operations and enabling 5G dynamic services through multi-action closed-loop feedback. The platform standard compliance, aligned with 5G network data analytics function and network exposure function constructs and mobile interface protocols. The platform is adaptable, supporting code-free ETL, dashboard and report generation. It's also customizable via KPIs, data stitching, enrichment, and aggregations. And the platform is vendor agnostic, supporting built-in data source and schema change management models. 5G analytics must pull data from many disparate data sources using different data access technologies. These high-value data sources include the control and user planes in the RAN, EPC, and IMS infrastructure, which require interface-specific network adapters and content parsing. The 5G services and applications themselves are rich data sources, which must be pulled for performance metrics, alarms, and logs, most often over proprietary interfaces. To access this data, an effective analytics platform must support flexible ETL models for interfacing the third-party radio, EPC, and IMS infrastructure via standard or vendor-specific APIs. and support optimized digital probes to directly ingest user and control plane data. This is exactly what we have engineered into the Ribbon Analytics platform, drawing on decades of protocol expertise in optimizing user and control plane ingest with our highly efficient digital probe when required. Let's now circle back to where we began and re-examine how Ribbon Analytics will power 5G use cases. Use cases such as immersive entertainment and video streaming will rely on the enhanced mobile broadband capabilities that 5G will deliver. To maximize user experience, analytics will play a key role in managing service levels of high bandwidth slices, modeling network behavior, and driving closed loop feedback into network orchestration and planning. Use cases such as IoT, smart cities, and machine-to-machine communications will rely on the massive machine communication capabilities of 5G. Security will be paramount as device attach counts drive into the tens of billions and geometrically expand the threat surface area. Analytics will be central to providing automated monitoring, detection, and mitigation to protect critical 5G infrastructure. We've already seen a glimpse of this threat with high-profile attacks using IoT devices infected with malware. Arguably the most notable to date was the Mirai attack in 2016, which brought down critical DNS infrastructure. These threats cannot be ignored, and analytics must be woven throughout the security stack. Use cases such as telemedicine, gaming, and autonomous vehicles will require ultra-low latency that 5G will deliver. Analytics must distribute and run optimally at the network edge, providing actionable insights in real time at machine speed to ensure that critical applications never fail and user experiences are maximized. It is with these use cases in mind that we have shaped our Ribbon Mobile Analytics offer for 5G. As we reach the end of this presentation, there are some key takeaways I'd like to leave you with. First, analytics is central to the success of 5G, derivative use cases, and adjacent technologies. Analytics enables operators to realize fully connected, on-demand, cognitive 5G networks and services at any time over any modality. The Ribbon Analytics platform is architected for 5G and currently deployed in mobile networks. We are doing this today. And lastly, Ribbon Analytics directly supports and enables critical 5G use cases via real-time actionable insights for service assurance, security, and data monetization. I'd like to thank you for your time and encourage you to reach out to the Ribbon team to learn more about our 5G strategy and industry-leading products.
Capitalize on the 5G wave with Ribbon Analytics, a cloud-native, real-time, big data platform and application suite, giving service providers actionable insights for monitoring, troubleshooting, and service assurance, and enabling you to correlate cross-domain data from networks and services for end-to-end visibility, so you can reduce complexity and cost. Ribbon Analytics has continuous learning, deep insights, and automation, delivering intelligence off the shelf. And it has software, cloud, and as-a-service deployment options. From the edge to the core, from any network, unparalleled insights, actionable intelligence, and effective outcomes. Uncork your networks, understand your customers, and unlock the potential of 5G.
Industries around the globe are ready to embrace 5G and make their private networks smarter. Take the example of the global rail industry, spending over 100 billion euros per year in railway technology. 5G private networks give rail operators an edge. Integrated traffic management systems holistically monitor the customer journey, making travel seamless, holistically, while location-based services and ultra-broadband enhance the customer experience. Real-time integrated travel systems allow for just-in-time logistics and bigger trains that travel closer together, delivering more freight. IoT makes rail safer, more reliable, and easier to maintain. Video and machine learning systems automate incident discovery and reporting and provide predictive maintenance, so everyone arrives to the station on time. Ribbon's 5G native transport network keeps you on track, providing secure infrastructure to backhaul system data with high bandwidth and low latency, delivering high capacity, real-time connectivity for streamed HD video. Enabling mission-critical IoT with deterministic connectivity. Securing crucial OT systems with hybrid slicing and encryption. Get on board and deliver secure, private 5G networks that will turn a choo-choo into a bullet train. All aboard with Ribbon's 5G native transport.
And now, our industry analyst panel, hosted by Vice President of Solutions Marketing at Ribbon, Sanjay Bhatia.
Hello, everyone. I'm Sanjay Bhatia from Ribbon Marketing. We have a great set of analysts today focused on 5G today and tomorrow. We have Adora Okeleke. She's a principal analyst for service provider operations and IT at Omdia. We have Mike Roberts. He's the principal consultant, service provider markets at Omdia. And then Scott Wilkinson, who's the lead analyst for optical and packet transport at Signal AI. Welcome to all of you.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.
So Mike, let's start with you, Mike. You've been tracking the global 5G market quite closely. So where are we today with the, given the pandemic, and then how quickly do you see the industry moving on with their 5G deployments?
Thank you, Sanjay. It's great, great question, and it's great to be here with you on the panel. Omdia and Informa Tech, we actually just conducted a global survey that asked that very question. Where are we today with 5G, given the global pandemic we're all living with every day? And this went out to more than 300 companies across the value chain in 5G, including to more than 100 communications service providers. And the results may surprise you. Among those service providers, the top answer, which was chosen by 37% of respondents, was that COVID-19 has actually had a positive impact on 5G. How's that? Well, specifically by accelerating 5G investment or launch plans, or triggering new 5G investment cases and revenue opportunities. That surprised us. I mean, we knew that 5G is vital to the industry. We knew that it really is the future of the industry in a lot of ways, but it was surprising that, you know, the biggest answer was that the pandemic was positive for 5G. Now, of course, that's not the whole story. Our survey also found that a significant number of service providers, 34%, did say the pandemic has had a negative impact on 5G. In other words, a negative impact on in delaying their 5G investment or launch plans. Now that's less of a surprise. Obviously, given the situation that a lot of economies are in around the world, it's really no surprise that service providers have had to delay investment plans in one of the newer systems in order to save money. And that just leaves the remaining 29% of service providers who took part in the survey saying that the pandemic has had no impact on their 5G investment launch plans. That's also a little surprising, you know, given how it's impacted the economy broadly. But we interpret that as service providers seeing this segment is so important that they're moving ahead despite the challenges in the economies that we're facing currently. So if I have time just to briefly address the second part of your question, how quickly do you see the industry moving on with 5G? Well, the answer is the industry is moving on with 5G as we speak, even during the pandemic, but the picture's mixed depending on the type of company, the market segment, geography, and many other factors. But across the board, the industry remains bullish on 5G, but you really have to get down to the segments and individual parts of the industry to see exactly how that is taking shape across the world. Sanjay?
Yeah, very interesting, Mike. So this was a survey of, you said, 100 service providers or so?
That's right, near 100, yes.
Wow. Okay, great. So Scott, do you see similar things for the global transport market? Like what impact do you see on spending for transport moving forward? And does that translate to the deployment of infrastructure short-term that can be reused for 5G?
Generally, it's telecom is one of the few places that you really wanted to be during the COVID pandemic. Generally, I would agree. Think in the transport side of the industry, we have seen growth. And it depends on where you are. It depends on what kind of equipment you're looking at. But for the first half of the year, things have been going really, really well. Now, we just published this week our second quarter numbers for 2020, and things have started to turn a little bit. We're starting to hear a couple of vendors talk about, well, maybe things aren't going to continue to grow the rest of the year. Maybe CapEx has been essentially exhausted at the first part of the year, this incredible growth, these really good things that we've been hearing outside of APAC for the first couple of parts of the year. Maybe that's not going to continue for the rest of the year, and the second half might be flat. But essentially what has happened is COVID has made it very hard to predict anything. Demand has gone up. Absolutely. Everyone agrees with that. Demand has gone up across the board from the access all the way through the network. But operationally, it has been hard to get parts. It has been hard to get things manufactured. It's been hard to get customers to accept things. And that has especially hit new technology. So if there's a customer out there who hasn't tried something new, if it's a new transport technology or if it's 5G, if it's something they haven't evaluated, the labs aren't really available. And so it's not surprising to hear that some of the respondents to the survey you just talked about said that it's delayed. And that's probably because if they hadn't already started on it, they couldn't start now. So operational issues are the problem. And it's whack-a-mole. You have a problem that fixes itself in one part of the world, another one shows up in another part of the world. You're constantly doing what we call whack-a-mole, trying to keep track of that. But the impact for 5G in particular is going to be on specific technologies. And what we've seen is that in this pandemic era, there is money being spent, especially in access networks and aggregation networks. And if you look at aggregation hardware in particular, things like aggregation switching, that's generally been going up, and that benefits both wired and wireless technologies. And as 5G networks are being put out, people are coming out, the vendors are coming out with new technologies to enable that. They are now, because of this push towards the edge of the network, evaluating those a little bit faster. The only problem is things are slowed down because of the operational issues.
Wow. Very, very interesting, Scott. Seems like you got your pulse on this quite closely. Excellent.
Much as possible. It's a very hard environment to talk to people about. We have vendors who will give us great guidance for the next couple of months, but no one wants to talk about next year.
Yeah. It seems like that's a common theme across multiple industries, you know.
Yeah.
Awesome. Great input, Scott. So Adora, so you've been tracking the automation, analytics, and machine learning market, right? And this is more about the operations of these networks, the intelligence. So how do you see this tying into 5G and the management of the underlying networks?
All right. Thanks so much for the question. And you know, it's a pleasure to be on the panel today. I guess the one thing we all need to bear in mind about 5G and the rollout of 5G is that it will introduce a more complexity into the telco network, and several factors account for this complexity. First will be the fact that with a higher consumption levels of data services, we'll get more traffic within the network, and the 5G networks will obviously coexist with the legacy networks, 4G, 3G, 2G networks for some time. And also the introduction of features, 5G core features such as massive MIMO from down at the radio network level, through to network slicing, edge computing, and the disaggregation of hardware and software, and virtualization, within the core network. So all of these factors will contribute to more complexity within the network when it comes to managing the network itself. So, but the skills required to manage, this growing complexity isn't growing at the same pace at which the complexity of the network will grow. And so, operators need to begin to ask themselves, how can we augment existing workforce capabilities to manage this, this rather complex network? And that's, owes to the whole discussion around, we're hearing about automation, because automation will enable operators, simplify how they manage all of the complexity within within the network. Now, automation isn't completely new for the telco market. They've been, you know, automating processes for quite some time now, but the approach that they've taken will not scale effectively for them to manage the newer use cases within 5G network environment. And so, you know, there's been a lot of investigation around the use of AI analytics capabilities to enhance automation functions. And the main reason for that is because current automation capabilities rely on fixed policies and rules to define the automation workflows and operate. And, you know, the industry needs to move away from these rules that have been defined by humans and move more towards capabilities that are less dependent on humans and can scale over time. So with AI, with the AI capability, AI systems can, you know, learn from the massive amounts of data that will be generated by the increase in the network traffic within the network. They can learn patterns within the network, and these patterns then generate rules that then define the automation workflows. And an added advantage to using AI to drive automation is the fact that with machines, because they have such faster ways to, you know, process data, and they can learn a lot more at a faster rate than humans would. They can pick up on patterns that humans would have otherwise not been able to pick up. Do telcos need to wait until they deploy 5G networks? I really don't think so. They can actually start from now with their 4G networks to begin to build experience in terms of using this technology to optimize their networks, and then utilize this experience and then transfer learnings to managing the 5G networks when they finally roll out these networks. And there are examples of operators doing that. So SK Telecom is one that, you know, developed a system using big data analytics and AI to automate how they managing networks. They developed a system called Tango, which, you know, uses which was developed using 4G data sets, but now they've transitioned that to managing 5G networks. So there is value in investing in AI-based automation.
Awesome. Wow. So we've got multiple aspects here, right? We got the transport, we got the overall end-to-end network. And then of course the software-based and cloud-based architectures. And then on top of that, we have the automation and intelligence. So lots of moving parts, and it seems like you don't necessarily need to wait for the full deployments to happen to get going on many, many of these fronts. So very, very interesting. Great insight. Thanks, Adora. So let me ask all of you here, maybe I will ask Scott to start this one here. So given, you know, technologies like network slicing for shared or private environments, so how do you all see the importance of network slicing and multi-layer transport and those type of technologies for 5G deployments? Scott, you want to take that one first?
Sure. It's a nice spring off of Adora talking about the fact that you can start now with 4G networks. 5G, when people talk about the promise of 5G, the services that 5G is going to offer, when they talk about everything that you're going to get out of 5G, there's always three things. There's the high bandwidth, which everybody generally knows about, but low latency and massive connectivity are also a big part of that. And go back and look at all the presentations that have been made over the last year and a half. And the big opportunity is not just the bandwidth, but all these new things you'll be able to do. All those things require a different front haul, back haul network. You've got to have more capabilities underneath, whether it's edge computing or just lower latency devices or things like slicing. The reality, however, is that the most important thing right now for 5G today, the beginning of 2020, is that Apple will get an iPhone out that has a 5G logo on it and somebody be able to sell that service. The absolutely most important thing right now in the race to 5G is a handset that says 5G on it. So what's being deployed right now is 5G radios on top of 4G architecture. Just to get it out there, to get it out as many places as possible, as quickly as possible, and get the handsets out. But you're not getting the benefit of those other things, the low latency and the massive connectivity, those additional applications that Adora talked about earlier, the things that are going to make revenue long-term grow faster than just adding new bandwidth. And that's where you're gonna need TSN timing support, network slicing, mobile edge computing, all those other functionalities have gotta come in for you to be able to have those additional services work.
Awesome. Mike, any thoughts on this one? In terms of the technologies, underlying technologies that need to be deployed and what comes first?
Yeah, it's an interesting question. And I'll actually take off from Scott's point. And if you don't mind, kind of look at the service aspect, because I think there is this question of, you know, what's driving this? What's the reason? And, you know, I think what we're all aware of is that the industry, you know, does have a growth dilemma, certainly not the only industry. And it seems a little bit kind of crazy to say currently when, you know, demand has definitely spiked, you know, but the challenge for service providers is that, you know, you can't necessarily raise prices as a result of that. And so the service providers are really looking to 5G and network slicing and a lot of the other underlying technologies to develop some fundamentally new services. And Scott was alluding to this. I mean, you know, can you start to package up higher bandwidth, higher quality of service, lower latency into an entirely new service that's going to reach a new market segment and start to actually move the dial on your commercial results? I mean, for a lot of service providers, the answer to that question is yes, basically. And of course, network slicing, multi-layer transport, there's a whole panoply of technologies and strategies and business models that need to come together for this to happen. But it really does have to happen for the industry to have the type of future that it wants to have.
Awesome, awesome. So I'll you know, the last question I'll ask you about your crystal ball and how fast things happen. But before that, let me ask Adora, maybe she give us some insights on this one. So Adora, what are the key opportunities for either revenue generation or OpEx containment with 5G? And like, what would your thoughts be for service providers and other providers to speed up their infrastructure deployments and revenue engines there?
I think there's quite a number of opportunities, both from a revenue and OPEX perspective. If we look alone at what we expect, you know, network traffic growth to be like, we expect it to grow by three times the current value, or the value it was at 2019. Now that in itself opens up opportunity, you know, in itself presents both opportunities as well as risks, you know, for operators, and you know, our analysis, our understanding is that, you know, about 80% of this traffic will be video related traffic, and then the question is, you know, what kind of services can, you know, operators begin to roll out? I will probably, you know, leave the service question to Michael, because, you know, that's his specialty. But from an OPEX perspective, I think it is an opportunity. It presents an opportunity for operators to potentially utilize the data that will be coming into the network to identify more effective ways of managing the network, right? So if we put OPEC operational costs today comes at about 60% of revenues, which is really on the high side. So operators need to really manage OPEX effectively. So what do they do? You bring in capabilities such as AI and automation to help streamline, you know, the level of costs and efforts going into the networks.
Yeah. So let me maybe, you know, I'll ask Scott, you and Mike to take out your crystal balls here and see, looking, moving forward, like, what do you see the timelines? Scott, you mentioned, you know, the iPhone and the 5G devices are key in this equation. So moving forward, what do you see the timeline for these exciting new 5G applications, and how do you see the service providers benefiting, you know, maybe beyond gaming and private networks, you know, that are already, you know, there's quite a bit of discussion out there on those. So maybe Scott, you want to start?
Well, that's a big question. I will say it depends. How about that? If you're in India, 5G is something that's going to be a fixed wireless access replacement that's coming in a couple of years, because you've still got people on 2G. If you're in Korea, 5G's been around for a while and you're already using it. If you're in the United States, you've got several different people who've got different ideas of what 5G is deploying at different rates. You've got Verizon doing fixed. You got T-Mobile out there saying it's just going to be a sort of broadcast that everybody's going to have access to. What's more interesting to watch is the people who are talking about 5G private services, like a private LTE kind of service for enterprise. To Adora's point and to Mike's point about trying to make money off of these new services, that's where the things are going to get really interesting. Certainly timelines for 5G deployment for the kind of things that get mentioned at national conventions maybe in the last week, where you just get 5G capable phones out everywhere, that's going to happen relatively quickly in the United States. It's certainly happened in a lot of Asia. It's all over China. That's going to happen in Europe. The more interesting ones, the ones where these underlying technologies really matter, to Mike's point about trying to make money off of new services, that's going to take a little bit longer. And as I said earlier, things have slowed down because of COVID. New innovations generally across the board aren't happening as fast as they should because it's just hard to get people into labs to do things. So I'll take a little bit of a pass and say it should be happening this year, but it probably won't in most cases.
So Mike, just to conclude, what's your thoughts on this?
I would agree with Adora and Scott on this. The first point that I guess is easy to make is that it has become a lot more difficult to predict the future because, you know, we're living in a sort of a highly uncertain time. I would say, however, that clearly some of the more advanced applications that require more investment, you know, things have slowed down. Because really, you know, the focus is turned on to meeting this wave of demand. A lot of service providers are struggling to meet in a lot of cases, as Adora was saying. And, you know, it's kind of turned to the here and now. And some of these really valuable, interesting applications that are a bit farther out have slowed down, is something that we're hearing. But, you know, at the same time, as our survey showed, you know, people are still very bullish on 5G. I think it's just that it may slow down a little bit. And we're really advising operators to, you know, pick the quick wins that they think they can capitalize on and deliver in the current climate. That means they may have to be a little bit less ambitious, but there's still new services that can be developed, that can be rolled out in the current situation to help, you know, increase revenues in the short term, as well as the things that require more investment at all levels of the network and value chain, which are going to take more time, but will deliver more value in the long term. That would be my view.
Awesome, awesome. Well, let's see, maybe we do this next year and I ask you, how close were you to your predictions? Fantastic, no. So I want to thank all of you for your great insights. You know, it's a lot of interesting conversation here. I really appreciate it, and thank you, everyone.
Thank you, Sanjay.
Thank you.
Very much.
Thank you.
Thank you, Sanjay. Thanks, everyone.
So I hope you enjoyed that panel of industry analysts and their insights on 5G markets. We've had a lot of great questions come in, so let me see if I can address some of the questions that we haven't answered yet. So first one, let's see here. We see you have just announced that you've hired a senior executive, Sam Bucci. Can you tell us more about this? Absolutely, yes. We just announced this morning that Sam Bucci has joined Ribbon as the EVP and General Manager for our Packet Optical Networks business unit. So many of you may know Sam most recently from his 15 years at Alcatel-Lucent and Nokia. So Sam has managed growing multi-billion dollar global optical businesses, and we are excited to have him join our senior leadership team. Let's see, the next one. So you announced that you'll be publishing the results of your survey of hardcore gamers and their need for high-speed connectivity. Where can I get it? Absolutely, we'll be sending the white paper and the survey results to all of you who have registered for the event. But you can also get this study and much more at Ribbon's 5G Resource Center. This will be your one-stop shop for our white papers, blog posts, collateral, and videos regarding 5G. We will be continuously updating the content of that 5G Resource Center. So please be sure to bookmark it. And the URL is rbbn.com/5G-resources. The next question is, will this event be available to replay? Absolutely, yes. You'll be able to access a recording of today's session in that 5G resource center that I just mentioned by tomorrow. Let's see, the next one is, as 5G picks up momentum, how do you see the enterprises deploying 5G networks for their businesses? That's a great question. Enterprises will either build and control private 5G networks using their own infrastructure or purchase a network slice from a service provider, their 5G network. So the decision by the enterprise will mainly depend on the solution maturity, cost, levels of service assurance, and the security of the offerings. As many of you know, the recent CBRA mid-band spectrum auction just happened in the US. And of particular interest was that many utilities, universities, rural service providers participated in that auction, just highlighting kind of the focus and demand for 5G services also by the enterprise and critical infrastructure and industry vertical segments. Next question, are you doing anything extra to make your 5G solution more secure? Absolutely. Security is at the heart of everything we do. It's priority one, and it's designed in by our product teams at all levels of the product. So on the networking side, using hybrid slicing with hard slices for private overlay gives enterprise customers total confidence of network isolation, that their network, that the slice of the network that they're using is fully isolated. This is key as enterprises and critical infrastructure will likely represent at least half of the 5G business overall. On the management side, security is multi-layer from user control to restricted domains and encryption, especially at the optical layers and beyond. So, you know, again, security is built in to the Ribbon 5G native solutions. Next question, for the carriers you have talked to, what are their main reasons for being interested in hybrid slicing? Another great question, thanks for asking that. Multi-tenancy is a key near-term interest. So in the US, as many of you are likely aware, transport operators or wholesale operators provide backhaul services for multiple mobile operators using a single transport network. So there's great interest in hybrid slicing as a way to strongly isolate the backhaul that these transport operators are providing to one mobile operator versus another. That's what just one great example. The other one is obviously the fact that operators and service providers may want to segregate multiple service types based on their different needs and requirements, especially in terms of ultra reliable, low latency communications from you know, the enhanced mobile broadband part. So again, that's a very common point of discussion out in the industry, as you all are aware. And then lastly, a question on analytics. How would Ribbon Analytics handle the various rollout options for 5G that service providers are adapting? Another great question. So Ribbon Analytics covers this, you know, this transition phase across the different steps in three main ways. You know, first, we support virtual protocol analyzers that break out the 5G control and user planes as new radios are initially deployed with you know, the 4G packet core LTE EPCs. These analyzers also support the protocols for 5G, allowing a smooth transition for the standalone nodes. Second, the platform is inherently cloud native, which allows the ease of integration and expansion with 5GC services architecture. For those who are familiar with that, you know, enabling functions, I'll use some acronyms now, NWDAF and NEF type of rollouts and functions. So So that's the second point. And then the third, finally, is 5G voice will leverage existing IMS core to the fullest, I would presume. So we can support a combination of data blending between the new and existing data feeds. So these are some of the key examples of how Ribbon Analytics architecture is ideally suited to evolve with your migration and growth into 5G with new applications while seamlessly integrating the existing investments that you may already have made. So if we did not, there was a number of great questions that came in. If we did not get to all your questions today, we will certainly follow up with you post-event. So please stay tuned. And that was our last question here. So I will now hand it back to Bruce, our CEO, for closing comments. Bruce?
Great, thanks very much. On behalf of the entire Ribbon team, I want to thank you for joining us today. As I said at the outset, we hope this is the beginning of an ongoing conversation. Please do take the opportunity to visit the Ribbon 5G Resource Center that was mentioned in the Q&A. We'll be continually updating the content, giving you access to our latest perspectives on 5G. So thanks again for joining us, and I hope to see everyone soon.